In this video, I will be reviewing the Shizuku 210mm Gyuto from Yukurosaki. Hello guys, I'm Chef Bunko and I used to work in a Japanese restaurant. Make sure to subscribe to know more about cooking and knives. Before we start with the review, I want to go over some disclosures. I bought this knife with my own money. No one sends them to me or paid me to use this knife or to make this video. If you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up since that will help the channel a lot. Now with the disclosures away, let's start by reviewing the Gyuto Shizuku from Yukurosaki. The Shizuku Gyuto from Yukurosaki is packaged in a cardboard box and the only indication of the knife version is at the bottom. The knife is protected with newspaper and it is an excellent material to absorb moisture. The paper has limited protection and therefore it is advisable to ask the retailer to package the product with extra padding. The knife comes with some VCI paper wrapped around the blade. This protects the knife from forming corrosion on the blade and is especially helpful for knives with a high carbon material. Make sure you do not cut yourself by removing the newspaper. It is advisable to slide the newspaper away at the spine. The Shizuku Gyuto has an SG2 or also called the R2 core material. It comes with an outer softer stainless steel cladding. The cladding is very visible and adds to the aesthetics of the knife. The blade has a chiseled, hammered finish and comes with a brushed vertical finish above the knife profile, which helps break down water content from food to stick less on your blade. The knife comes with a half-tang octagonal rosewood handle, which means that the blade is partially glued into the handle. The knife Rockwell hardness is specified with a Rockwell of 63. If used at home, you can get away with 8 to 9 months before needing a whetstone touch-up if you regularly hone your knife with a honing rod. The SG2, or also called the R2 powdered steel, has excellent rust and corrosion resistant properties. Most Japanese knives with a high Rockwell hardness go for a sharper knife over durability. That is also why they add a cladding to protect the blade from any potential damage, and it prevents the knife from breaking. Since the knife prioritizes sharpness over durability, you need to keep in mind that you cannot do the following things. It should not be used to slice through frozen food, bones, cheese, hard bread, or force your way through other tough food like chocolate or crushed nuts. And you should not twist or pry the food open with the knife since that can cause chipping. Yukurosaki added a very artistic hammered pattern on the knife, which helps prevent food from sticking on your blade. The blade also has a rough polish with deep vertical scratch lines, which helps break down water content so that food will not resist your cut because it can't use suction from the water content to cling onto your blade. The blade profile of this Gyuto is also very nicely done. It maintains a straight blade while having a gentle curve at the front. The heel of the knife has a slight curve to prevent any hard stops. The knife balance point of this knife is in front of the chiseled kanji. Depending on the gripping style, the knife balance point will shift. It is considered front heavy if you pinch grip the knife at the neck area. If you pinch grip at the blade or in front of the chiseled kanji, the knife will be middle balanced. Keep in mind that you shift your middle fingers towards the choil by doing so. Yukurosaki rounded the choil area and polished it nicely so there won't be any discomfort if you grip the knife a bit more in front of the chiseled kanji. The traditional handle is an octagonal handle, which is a well-balanced design for comfort and grip. The handle comes with a rosewood handle, and when the handle starts to feel dry, you can apply a thin layer of mineral oil. It will prevent the wooden handle from drying out and splitting. Most traditional handles comes with a colored top part. This top part is usually a thin layer of resin to prevent water damage on the rosewood handle. The downside of this kind of handle is the durability. A traditional handle is less impact resistant since it is partially glued into the handle. However, a Japanese knife with a high Rockwell isn't impact resistant in the first place. Therefore, I do not recommend the handle grip since it affects the glued part and blade. the spine and the choil are nicely polished. The rounded heel area is also comfortable for those that want extra control by shifting the grip to the front. The knife also has a distal spine taper, and there's no noticeable flex during use. The most exciting part about the Yu Kurosaki knife is that he starts with a very thick neck area and adds a very aggressive distal spine taper. It adds extra grip and comfort when you pinch grip at the neck area. You also get a sturdier glute part compared to the thinner neck. It is also interesting to know that this knife is front heavy, and dependent on your preference, this balance point is not for everyone. However, you can always shift your grip a bit more forward for a middle balance point. In return, you also get more control, and it is ideal for more precise cutting work. Despite the thicker spine, he managed to reduce the weight without sacrificing the sharpness. The sharpness is maintained because of the lovely profile taper. And at last, there's also plenty of knuckle clearance on the knife. The knife is suitable for home cooks. However, you must know what you can and cannot do with it. It is advisable that you know how to sharpen your knives properly before investing in this knife. Considering the price point, you will regret damaging the blade due to improper use or lack of knowledge in what it is capable of doing. While the knife is suitable for professional cooks, you need to consider where you want to use the knife. You will love how long the knife will stay sharp without needing to hone the edge. Now on to this knife's care and maintenance. It is not recommended to use a diamond honing rod or a coarse like an 800 grit ceramic rod. My recommendation is a ceramic rod with a minimum of 1000 grit. The higher you go, the less material you remove with each honing session. It is also inadvisable to use a bamboo cutting board, since bamboo is quite hard and will dull the knife faster. You should always hand wash and dry your knife after use, since this prevents water damage on the blade and handle. You should never use the sponge, abrasive side, or any abrasive material to clean the knife. You will destroy the polish of the knife and remove the vertical lines that were added to break down water content from food. That's it for this video. If you have any questions or other opinions, leave them in the comment section below. If I helped you decide, please give this video a thumbs up, since that will help the channel a lot. If you want to know more about cooking and knives, please subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Thank you for watching, and I see you in the next video.